I'd like to introduce Ramakant Maharaj, a direct disciple of Nisargadatta Maharaj. I'm very pleased to meet you. Maharaj, can you tell me a little bit about your background, your childhood, or early years in your life?
Early years I was from a native place. My education completed in a native place. Then I came to Mumbai. Somewhere some small services I've been. Then coincidentally with some of my relatives approached Nisargadatta Maharaj. And then after some 1 month, 2nd October 1962, Nisargadatta Maharaj given me Nama Mantra, Guru Mantra. Since then, I'm visiting Nisargadatta Maharaj and they are listening to his lectures. Meditations are the most important. Meditation every day you visit to Nisargadatta Maharaj.
So you were with Maharaj for nearly 20 years?
About 19 years.
And
since 1962 to 1981.
And what was it like as a disciple with Nisargadatta Maharaj himself for you? How did it feel?
His speech, his lectures are very touching, very exceptional. But at that time, I'm not so much mature to understand what he was saying. But gradually he used to say that, listen to me. And every day he delivered in lectures, so by 6.30 to 7.30 like in the evening. I was listening, just listening and doing bhajan.
You're now teaching in the ashram here in Nashik. Are your teachings the same as your master's, Nisargadatta, or slightly different?
Teaching the same, but approach maybe words are very different. Principle the same. To accept yourself, there is no God, no Brahman, no Atman, no Paramatma. It's the principle of spirituality. So the same thing in different words I'm placing before the devotees, the ultimate truth.
So you basically summarized the teachings there very briefly.
Of course, yes.
You're part of a very strong lineage here. Can you speak about the lineage and the masters? Please, thank you.
Basically, that head of the lineage is Dattatreya. This is a Natha Sampradaya. So, the disciple of Dattatreya, Revannath Maharaj, is our head of our lineage. Since then, his disciple Karsadeshan Maharaj, earlier Karsadeshan Maharaj. Lineage started through Karsadeshan Maharaj 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. And then, Gurulingajanga Maharaj came across with the Karsadeshan about Karsadeshan Swami, about 300 years back,
300 years.
At Kollapur, at Tiruvanthapuram. And then from Gurulingajanga Maharaj to Hosai Maharaj, Raghunathaya Maharaj, Siddharameshwar Maharaj, there's so many disciples of Gurudev and all. That lineage started, then Siddhartha Maharaj and Ranjit Maharaj, like that. That lineage started.
So, can I ask, what do you see as the role of the guru in the teachings?
See, guru's importance is that he is inviting attention of the individual, the silent listener, that except yourself, nothing is there. We know about Brahman, Atman, Paramatman, God, it is the world knowledge, the eternal knowledge. But according to Nisargadatta Maharaj, except your selfless self, there is no God, no Brahman, no Atman, no Paramatma. So, be calm and be still.
Can I ask, what do you mean by self-realization? Sometimes you say it's easy to attain, but other times it's very difficult. It's easy and yet difficult.
Just to know oneself in real sense, we are knowing ourselves in body form, that is not your identity. Your identity is unidentified, invisible, anonymous identity. So, your spontaneous presence is the cause of the world, is the production of the world. So, you are ultimate truth, you are unborn. The devotees or people like want some happiness, peace of mind, tension-free life, fearless life. That can only happen once you know yourself in real space. You are totally unborn, but even though you are thinking that I am born, I am going to die, these are the concepts, these are illusory thoughts. This knowledge enlighten you, realize you, make you realize next, what is the ultimate truth, final truth.
You have said to me that good knowledge is dry and of little use. Why is dry knowledge?
No, this is just having Brahman, Atman, Paramatman. This is the Polish word we are using, or did it? It is not say practicable, right? Because you make self inquiry. So out of this knowledge, I read so many books. Somebody read so many books. You approach so many matters. Whether I am happy, whether I am careless, whether I am tension free, whether I am peace. The question is, the answer is no. That means little knowledge. So we have to go under some process. So entire power, entire energy, entire spirit is in you, but you are ignoring, you are underestimating yourself. So therefore, go deep and deep and see yourself in real sense. You are not in a body form. You are not born. You are not in a body form earlier. So you have to confirm that, conviction support you there. I'm not a body, I'm not going to remain a body. Do I have using this body, it is an illusion.
Following on from that, there are a couple of books such as I Am That by Nisargadatta with his teachings, and Master of Self-Realization of Siddharameshwar Maharaj's teachings. Is there anything that makes these books different from dry? Can they be more alive, living?
Siddharameshwar Maharaj, Siddhartha Maharaj, you have the same message. One message is accept yourself, bless yourself, there is no God, no Brahman, no Atman, no Paramatman. So all saints, all the so-called martyrs, in their different speech, given one message, that accept yourself, there is no master, no God, no Brahman. So know yourself in their sense.
Why would you say these books are those two, I Am That and Master of Self-Realization, are not so dry? I mean, I Am That is a book you would recommend to people, isn't it?
You undergo all this knowledge. See the say guidelines. You say that. What is saying, I Am That, and all these books, inviting attention of the reader that you are ultimate truth, you are final truth. So all speeches, all books, all spiritual books, given one message that accept yourself, there is no God. To say God, your spontaneous, invisible presence is required.
To try and compare your teachings and the lineage with another tradition, what would be the closest, or is it unique? Is this tradition and the teachings that you're giving?
It is having some scientific reason. So we are given the Guru Mantra, Nam Mantra, considering the sensitivity of the spirit. The spirit, its nature of spirit is that what you say, impress it, come out with this same way, say. So that the Nam Mantra, meaning of the Nam Mantra, I am Brahman, Brahman, I am like that. So she considers the sensitivity of the spirit. This mantra is given after but reciting that mantra. So realization process will be spontaneous inside. Your inner mantra will say, forward, will be come with all this knowledge. It's responded with knowledge. Already we are having. But you are not knowing, you are unaware of your knowledge, you are unaware of your identity. And so therefore this process of discipline of mantra is required.
Anne was asking about Shankaracharya. Is there a difference? Does Shankaracharya's teachings lead into
same teaching? This is as Shankaracharya says, to say I is illusion, to say you it is illusion, to say Brahman it is illusion, the entire world is illusion. The same message given by all the pillars of spiritual parts.
Well, thank you for your time. I can't think of any more questions at the moment. Thank you very much for your time. I'm sure that many people will be interested to know that you are teaching here in Nashik, and we do hope shortly to be able to tell some people in Europe, America.
Therefore, I mean, self-inquiry, self-knowledge, self-reading. There are three stages. Everybody reading so many books, everybody talking about the Brahman, Atman, Paramatman, God. It's very easy to talk. But one should question oneself, out of this knowledge, what I earn, what I got, whether I am completely free from this fear of death, where I have got complete peace, where I am, say, full happy, complete happiness, without any material thought. That should be question oneself. The answer is no. Something is a little knowledge. Be practical, everything within you. But we are searching here and there. We are ignoring searcher. We are ignoring finder. It means that you have a tremendous power, but you are unaware of that power. You are underestimating yourself. Say, I am a man or a woman. That is not your identity. This identity is supposed to be dissolved some other day. Body is having some time limit. But you are everywhere, you are omnipresent. Just like a sky. If at all you want to compare, you compare just like a sky. So we are bonded with the body knowledge, full body knowledge. Therefore we are trying to find out where should we have happiness, where you get complete peace. So complete peace, happiness, these are the words. So just think how I was prior to beingness. At that time, we need not require any God, Brahman, Atman, these are words of. After dissolving the body, what is my status? I don't know. So, all this requirement of the God, Brahman, Atman, so many things are there. The body related. To have this, that is, we are taking the material cause. That is illusion. So, we have to come out from the illusion. What is the reality? The reality placed by the masters. Reality of the listener, invisible, anonymous listener. So that is the what is the use of that? Then after knowing yourself in real sense, you will be completely out of fear. Because I am unborn, why should I fear of the death and birth? I have no birth, no death. The question of hell and heaven never arise. The rebirth and all these concepts are there. So many things are there. So that just to know yourself in real sense, spiritual is most important. Okay.
Thank you.